Hi everyone, I'm going to show you how to modify your existing Gotek drive that has been flashed with the HxC 2001 firmware to have a sound mod. What does the sound mod do? Well, basically turns it from this into this. Sounds pretty cool, right? Alright, what you need is one Gotek drive. This one has already been pre-flashed with the HxC 2001 firmware. You will also need a screwdriver, Phillips head, to open it up. You'll also need some header ribbon cables. You commonly see these with Arduino projects. They have a female connector on both ends. You can get that from Fleabay or any good electronic store. You'll also need a piezo buzzer. This is not the magnetic type, this is just your classic piezo buzzer you see in PCs. You can get these from Fleabay or from good electronic store as well. So the first thing you need to do is you need to get a pair of these ribbon cables off. Simply just tear a pair off. There we go. And what you're going to do is you're going to attach these leads to the end of this, and you're going to remove this protective little sticker. I know your time's precious, so here's one I prepared earlier. As you can see, it's all hooked up. You've got the long end connected to one lead, and you've got the short end connected to another lead. So basically what you need to do is you need to get your Gotek drive, here's one I've opened earlier, and you're going to connect it to the JB header, which is just here. You can see it's right next to the DS0 jumper. So what you're going to do is the one with the long leg off the piezo buzzer, you're going to connect to the connector that is closest to the end of the drive, and the other one to the other end. As you can see, it goes like that. And then what you can do is you can run the cable underneath and just lay it out the piezo wherever you actually want it to be inside the drive. Again, I know your time's important, so here's one I prepared earlier. As you can see, that's all neatly arranged, all neat and tidy. You can sticker it down, hot glue it if you want, but honestly, you don't really need to. I mean, how often are you going to shake your computer? Anyway, once you've got that, you need to put the lid back on, and we're ready to give it a go. Again, your time's important, so here's one I prepared earlier. The lid's back on, it's all neat and tidy, it doesn't stick out that much. That will go in any computer quite easily. And then all you need to do is get your USB floppy drive, make sure that you've actually got the HxC firmware from 1st of August 2017 on there, and we're ready to good to go. Now, again, your time's important, so here's one I prepared earlier. Ready to go, let's try it out. So here's my Amiga 600 that I'll be using my Gotek drive on. I'm going to be using it as an external drive. I've got an old external third-party floppy drive where I've removed the old broken floppy drive and replaced it with the Gotek. I've got my USB stick in the Gotek ready to go, and it's set to slot zero because I want to bring up the selector. On the Amiga itself, I've gone into the boot menu and I'm going to boot off DF1. So you can hear that the sound is already on. It is on by default in the firmware. I'm currently using firmware version 3.0.19.2a, which is 1st of August 2017. And all I have to do now, if you want to change the settings, is I'm going to go up to SD Media Files, A Selections, go down to HxC Drive Settings, and you can see Track Step Sound is on. If I turn that off, the sound will turn off. So let's exit out of that. I want to leave it on for now. We're going to save and reboot. I already know what floppy I want to try booting from. Okay, rebooting, going back to the boot menu. And now I'm going to go to disk number 14 because that's where I know my floppy disk is. Give it a few seconds to settle and do the disk change. And let's boot on. And there's International Karate in all its glory. So there you go, guys. That's the sound mod. It's very easy to do. It only works on the current HxC firmware. Don't bother trying doing it on the CORTEX firmware. It doesn't have support for it. I'd also recommend that you don't use the old stepper motor version of the sound mod. Apparently it causes some reliability problems with some people. I haven't seen that myself, but there seems to be enough chat about it to suggest that it's true. Any questions? Put them in the comments below. Cheers.